See, what's wrong with this piece?
There's something wrong with it. Can you figure it out? What do you think is wrong with it? Your brain's going, it's not real. Your brain, for some reason your brain's going, this is, no, it doesn't, there's something wrong with it. There's something wrong with it. It's right here. It's not a perfect circle. It was like a kink in the armor. The impenetrable armor. There, that's better for you, even though you've never seen that point of view. Now it looks more real. Why does it look more real? Why? Because I'm making a more perfect circle? It says a lot about your programming. Wake up! You've never seen this with your eyes at this distance. You've only seen pictures that have been paintings. I'm begging you to wake up. Say they're in charge of this shape are about to send you to war. They're all going to go underground. They do this. It's like a ritual culling. Before you wake up to, this is their control. This picture telling you this is the shape of the earth you're on. When you say earth, I say earth, an image will be drawn up in your mind of earth, like the totality of it. And it's interesting because I'll say earth, and then you have a picture of a ball immediately show up in your mind. But you've never actually seen the earth as a ball. So when I say world or earth, and then suddenly you see a globe, until you don't see a globe, you're still somewhat brainwashed. Or you're brainwashed, and it's there. Until I can go earth, and then you see a flat plane or the horizon. Right? Or they're like, kif-kif, neck and neck, you're still somewhat within the program. World. Still got it showing up, but you've never actually seen that. That's just an image repeated. Earth shows up, huh? It's just an image that's repeated. You never saw that point of view. You never saw that point of view. And yet it's so easily readily available in your head. And when I tell you and debate this, whether it's flat or a ball, you'll say, I believe it's a ball. But yet it's the image that always shows up in your mind. Why do you say you believe it's a ball? Because you can only say that, and it doesn't feel right to say, I know it's a ball. Of course, I say flat, immediately you think square. Why do you do that? Because if it's not a circle, it's the square? Because this is flat? Isn't that funny? Every time you've actually seen the earth as a ball, it's always been through a flat surface. Paper. TV screen. Computer screen. Smartphone. TV screen. Kind of like a window screen. You know, kind of like screening. Kind of like screening reality. The screen is like a filter between you and the real thing. I'm going to tell a vision, screen, program. You go to bed with the TV on, right? And you shut your eyes, you're not going to be able to dream. You're just going to have the carryover of the TV signal, whatever commercial, infomercial selling you DNA. And if you take this cleaning product, your shoes will stay white forever. This is the non-wash fabric. I mean, that for only $2.99. Like, that's just going through your head. Well, the weather tomorrow, Barack Obama, that's what's going through your head while you sleep for 8 hours. How are you gonna dream? How are you gonna have, like, imagine in dialogue with the woman of your dreams or on another plane, another dimension, when you have like, and for only $10,999. So you guys are palladiums. I mean, I don't know what, you know, like, wow, so this is the Valley of God and the dreams. $2.99, call today. The weather tomorrow, climate change, global security, ISIS, while you're going to bed. That's crazy. You're going to bed with the TV on, you're fucking programmed for 9 hours. Okay. So every time you do see the Earth as a ball, it's flat. And so why do you need to think it's a square if I say it's flat? Why do you need to think, oh, it's flat, like it's a pancake? Like, where do you get this idea of an edge? I'll tell you where you get where you get the idea of an edge. From this circle, there's the edge. So any other model I bring up to you, you gotta have an edge. You gotta carry over this habit of seeing the whole thing, like you do here. And you think, that's it, nothing beyond, it's just black. Yeah, that's the area they censored, dum-dum. How do you know? You've never seen this point of view. Back again, you've never seen this point of view, I just repeated it to you. Which way looks more realistic, this way? No, this way. Because that's the way you usually see it. Africa at the top. Get a good look. Get a good look at your thing. This is your world. This is it. It's like, what are we on? What are we on? I could see like some Jesuit. Because they would always send the Jesuits out to the new turf. Any new land. Okay, before the armies, can we control their minds? How do you do that? Well, we got to entice them. Okay, well, why don't we entice them with the crucifix and this? Like the fact that we discovered everything. That's why we're coming from the water. Hey, you know what? We're coming from the oceans. They've never seen white skin before. I think we could push this on them. You know? And if they believe in one God, well, then we'll just say, hey, it's the same God as us. We found everything. Here's a crucifix. This guy died for your sins, sinner. Worship this and the crucifix. I think we got him. And if we don't got him, then I'll call you guys for backup and then we can wipe him out like the Iroquois or the Aztecs or the Mayans. And they got a spear and they got, wait. Oh, that's right. Peace, I come in peace. This, I come from the ocean. I come from the ocean, I come from the places you didn't go, obviously. Look at the size of our boat. We're way more advanced. This is it. This is the world. It's not flat, it's not a square anymore. It's a circle. It's pretty fucking primitive. So, I mean, you go through the hippie 60s and you're still saying it's this, but you've never actually had an event where people could actually see it. While people are wondering why black people weren't equal and women weren't equal and all sorts of philosophical, political models of socialism and democracy and defining it, people were going into everything you've been telling them about what it is to be a human being and free for the last 40, 50 years to 2,000 years since the Magna Carta, and it was just a matter of time before they go, well, wait a minute, how do we know it's a ball? Okay, everybody calm down. Look, shut up, TV's on. Look, he's going on the moon. Oh, and a matter of fact, that's actually an opportunity to get a picture of the ball. So, you carry over into the flat earth now, a finite edge, with like, you know, an electrical dome and a little snow globe and another even more pathetic cartoon than this. This is pretty advanced painting or censored image, like a round window in the rocket, turn off the lights, it gives us the black, just film Africa. I mean, this is advanced. So you're gonna go from this, which is pretty good deception, to an even more childish toy-like drawing? I'm not buying it. If you're gonna infiltrate the flat earth by trying to say there's an ice wall and then it drops into space, or it's like a glass wall or a glass ceiling and there's aliens outside,
that could shake it like a snowplow. And we're in some experiment petri dish for like overlords from the Anunnaki and all that fucking nonsense. I'm out. I'm watching all you face group groups that are like pushing this fucking. It's gotta be. I gotta see the whole thing. No, you don't. You don't know until you go across the South Pole. It's not happening up there because it can control, you know, the opinion of the person going up there. Either by shooting the rocket down and no witnesses and just saying, hey, I saw it. That's what they do with these little events. And it's easy to get a couple sellouts. People have no ethics. You know, $1,000 an hour for security. You got to go up there and say you did it. Okay, sign here. Sign here before I tell you what the project is. Okay, you signed it. Now you can't talk about what I'm about to tell you. Okay, we're not actually going really high, but we got to let people think that we're going high because of the Russians. So can you fake it? And then cut to the Russians. Rablo Vlaska, Skankuntra Laslu, whatever they're doing. They're saying the same thing in Russian. Sorry, but, you know, don't, my Russian's not up to snuff, but, I mean, Rasa-nasa. Rasa-nasa, lasa-blasa. Into space. So if you gotta have like an edge, it's because you're like in this fast food globalism where you see the edge and you wanna, well, give me the edge now. No, there's just ice and then another big geothermal earth pond with land on it and another rotating sun around a magnetic rock that's called the magnetic north in that pocket. And then there's ice and then another pocket. It's huge. You know, the infinitely expanding universe is this. For all you know, on the edges, it's just like magma, molten lava come into contact, exploding and hardening with all this air. And it's like massive. And there's like tribes all along this huge galactic floor. The length of infinity, 360, extending all around the North Pole. The UN flag, but continuing past the last rung. Anything with an edge, you know, that's disinfo. Now, I could say I believe because you're allowed to believe. You're allowed to because belief is like the catalyst and fuel for an imagination. So it's very important. Anybody says that, you know, a belief is a psyop or it's disinfo, no, that's the freedom of an imagination, is to believe in something and the possibility of something. Anybody shows you an edge, that's disinfo. Anybody says they know it's a snow globe, that's disinfo. Now, there might be people in the movement who need that to get to the next point, but I would drop it sooner or later because it's obviously going to take away my credibility on saying the Earth is flat. Because right now, if it's not a circle, it's a square. And I see it with people who debate it. They end up saying, I believe. Yeah, you're entitled to believe in God or religion, but what's your God? Because that's from the military. And the people in charge of that image, the leaders of that world, the globe, that they keep saying globe, because they're accomplice, they're about to take you to war. They do this every 60 years. So the people in charge of that world, your world, the globe world, they're gonna go underground while all of you shoot at each other. Or while they give the orders to shoot rockets, what, over borders? Over gas? Over money. Well, money is not even backed by gold. You could print up as much as you want. So you're about to send the world at war over borders because of finances, but you guys are just printing up fiat currency through your central banks that you all own. No, so this is not about money. So this is not about nations. This is about...
world is flat and there's nothing you can do about that.
Because they know you're getting conscious and waking up and now you're starting to grow into your senses again. Your eyes are becoming investigative instruments as opposed to passive garbage receptacles of their images. You don't look out the window, you don't look up at the sky. You think your muffler is changing the sky. And they're outside your window while you're watching TV and they're telling you you're ruining the planet with your car. Spraying the sky. Don't you hear the planes? So let's talk about not only how they could take me down. I mean, is somebody going to try to say that I'm crazy? that I'm a dangerous mind? Well, there's individuals that are like, they're having a bit of a shock treatment with reality that, you know, because granted, I did have like many years trying to prove the earth was a ball when somebody brought this up to me. And from what they told me, you gotta look at all these things, that's your proof. Did you ever think and question? Anybody can make that shit up? And as long as I ran into that, I didn't have I didn't have a proof unless I could go clearly across the South Pole without some UN sanctioned Southern Polar Authority. Let them know, if they're really there for science, let them know the way I want to go in, but be steadfast on going in that way. And I could go in any way and then come out, if it's a ball, on the other coastline at the expected time it would take to cross the landmass in what we call a double traverse. Not just go to the South Pole and then go back the way you came in, but go to the South Pole and keep going. Whatever South Pole they say that is, while constantly maintaining a straight line. That's not done with witnesses, and the people who go are military scientists. So, no. It's that way. You don't go, well, I go around the world all the time in a plane, and it's like, hey, look at this guy, man, I've been in a plane, you haven't seen the curve of the earth. It's like, your brainwash doesn't account for your sense, your vision. Brainwash doesn't account for seeing. Go back up in a plane, back out the fucking window, and then review whether you see a curve. Because if you think you saw a curve, that's how strong it is. You can't see a curve if you're like 3-4 miles up, on if it is a ball of a 7,000 mile diameter. You can't. It's gonna look even everywhere you go because you're on a ball, buddy. Anywhere you go on that ball, it's gonna look even the horizon because you're on a ball. You're on a sphere. So you see a curve out in the end, you're not on a sphere, buddy. You got bigger problems. You're on a cylinder. Because there it is on the edge of the horizon. Let's continue the curve. You can't be on a sphere if we're gonna see a curve. Because even on a sphere it'll look flat. We went over this in Curvature of the Earth brainwash. So, that's it. So when you said you want to go across the South Pole, I was like, okay, it's starting. People are now coming.
Yeah, well, I'm down. Yeah, whatever I can do.
It's not what they show you. We're talking about, there's cracks and crevices that are 2,000 feet deep before they hit dirt. Sheer ice drops. There's dunes that are just snowpack on top of snowpack that go 10 kilometers high, higher than any mountain on Earth.
What about flying?
Your instruments can fail. You gotta have enough gas. You're only gonna go so far. We gotta have basically these drop-off points, and we have to have like almost like a chain relay feeding the main operation. And we have to have like a helicopter or plane that'll land on the snowcat. These are big snowcats. The Nazis had them. They're very like steampunk. They're fucking twice the size of this room. You can land a Cessna. It's not up there, the ship. Straight across. They got everybody looking up in the stars because they can't go. But the perimeter security around the South Pole is so heavy and so organized, so coordinated. And there's such a collaboration between Russia and the United States and Britain and Norway. Meanwhile, they're about to have a meat machine over in Ukraine, but down there and up there, they all get along. So this is, it's about our freedom of movement. And the United Nations Declaration of Human Rights, that every human being has the right to move and have access. And what we want to do is move in a straight line, uninterrupted, straight. See where we go. Technically, if we're fools, we should just end up right back where we started. But at what point do we get shot at, or things fall apart, or it turns into foul play? That's what I want to find out.
Right, yeah.
So, and right now, we're at the point where we're being bullied. Everybody's being bullied. But my idea is I'm gonna on the functional business side, it's gonna be a boutique sound studio where the sets are always changing, the environment's always changing, and it's
backdrops that I'm working on, but in that environment, in a 5,000, 6,000 space warehouse or studio space, I want to house more and more content for the NASA channel. And that could be forecasting the weather, but the real weather forecast and how we make weather. I'd like to have the nightly news, but it's reported by people who are retarded and have Down syndrome or are mentally handicapped, and it's more cutting edge and more realistic than the news we get from people who aren't mentally handicapped. So, and also have, you know, live events and functions and stuff like that. My ultimate goal here is to make this reach a critical mass where it becomes trendy, where we're sporting t-shirts, where everybody just loves the fashion of the flat earth, and enough to get it at a point where there's almost like a wrestling match between the hollow earth people, the guy who thinks the sky is glass and it's concave, the diskers, the globalists, and of course the flat earthers who think there might be more land, which I think is the ultimate, I think the reason behind this, if it's a conspiracy or if all this stuff is not true. Like, and I wouldn't say it's all this stuff is not true. I would say all these graphics are not true. My main proof is the time-lapse image of the Earth from space where the clouds are not mutating in a 30% rotation. So, I mean, I think what happened is they did the CGI and they realized morphing the clouds while we're time-lapsing the speed of the Earth rotating doesn't look believable. So they thought, you know what, let's just put it out with the clouds not morphing because we could jeopardize the entire operation. But I saw it and it doesn't work because clouds morph and change in even chemtrails or contrails or whatever you want to call them. They change in the span of a half an hour. So to actually do a time-lapse of 30% of the Earth's spin in 3-4 seconds and the clouds aren't morphing or mutating or dissolving, that's a fraud. That's it. It's a fraud. You know, and I could stick by that. You can take me to court and you could argue to your heart's delight that clouds don't morph or change to say that's real. And they can't. And they won't. So we've got groups showing up now that are just going to create surface noise, try to drown this out, and twist it and morph it so people go out there pushing the argument and they got one half-truth in there or one wonky crazy thing that's been inverted. Like the guy there that you referenced there at Dubai, there's no curvature. Look here in New York, there's no curvature. You know the guy there who sounds like Neo? That guy there? That guy put out a map. He took every tenet that we're saying, but he put out this map where he said the South Pole is the North Pole, and it's the North Pole that's really 360 degrees, a complete poppycock. It doesn't even work with our model. But people are going around, and there's a group of people in the UK that are referencing him, and they're attacking his wonky map, which is fused with the rest of our tenets and stuff, and they're attacking it to me, and they're attacking it to this whole concept, to other people who have the real science on this possibility. So that's disinformation. Yeah, go ahead.
Great. It's more land. Just because they show you cartoons of the world, maps, doesn't mean that's what you're on in all of it. I mean, that would be a great way to like hide a good chunk of it. Maybe the chunk. Chunk you're on. You know why it's flat and why the world's gonna be flat from now on very soon? Because it's just cooler. It's just the way it is. It's the coolest thing. It's the coolest punk fuck you. It's the new punk. World's flat. What are you gonna do now? We all think it's flat. We're liars. Yeah. More cartoons. Yeah. When are you going to get the 7-Eleven 24-hour footage of the Earth as a ball spinning from one of those cameras on the space station? You let me know when that happens. Full globe spin. Because the shit you show me where the clouds don't move? Sped up? Yeah, world's gonna change. Because it's just cooler too.
Dude, do you realize what you're saying? You're saying that the Earth is not a ball. Do you know what the ramifications are? Did you really think this through? Like on religion, where we're from, belief, and real estate, the authority of governments, everything. Because you know what? It does hold it all together. When you think about it, it's like, why are you emperor? Because I'm emperor. Why are you emperor? Because I say so. No, you're not. Why are you emperor? Because I have armies. Well, you got money. How'd you get the money, all that? Because we figured out the way it is. Because we're in charge of the room. We set up the room. We placed the furniture. We invited you in. This is the shape of the room. This is the amount of space you have to enjoy yourself. This is it. This is the whole room. Yeah, this is the whole room. You wouldn't know if you go into a house and you're unblindfolded. If there's other rooms or how big the house is. Is the world that way? Did they rearrange the furniture a certain way and there's another room beyond the wall? It's the old Plato's cave. It's the old, how would you know? That's the shape of the earth. You've never been up there to see the point of view you think is what you're on. Now, I'm the guy, I'm a threat because I brought that up in 2015. I'm a messenger, okay? Picking my nose. That's it. Painting. You know, lovely women, doing live shows, doing comedy. You know, I had to put my shit aside to go, hold on a second. Before you all run off and kill each other in a world war here, this looks like a painting to me. How do you know this is like a real ball? The people want you to go off to war, kill each other. I mean, you've never seen this point of view. I'm just saying, I'm going to go back and do some portraits and some sea life and enjoy myself. By the way, that's a painting. Oh, by the way, clouds not moving from real time-lapse footage of the Earth as a ball in space, spinning 30% of the Earth, but the clouds don't actually mutate and dissolve like clouds do when I see fast-forward time-lapse just from the ground looking up at sky, or the movie Baraka.
As much as people will say, well, I've got my own problems, it's like, no, you don't understand. This is bigger than your own problems.
This is all problems flow from. Yeah. All problems flow from because it's the container of your problems. You know, I could basically have you worried about Ukraine and Russia because you have got a picture of the globe in your head. You know, so I could basically make you react any way when at any time. As a government intelligence agency or somebody engineering scenarios or intelligence scenarios in order to have a problem reaction solution engineering to society through the globe, you know? But the minute that globe is out, you have people renouncing the globe, and it's like, I'm not playing ball anymore.
Yeah.
Like, literally. And it's like, so the whole point here is like, you want to have World War III, and you're about to go to war, but you don't even know if this picture of the Earth is a fucking cartoon.
Yeah.
The people who say they run this picture, this cartoon, are about to send you out to kill yourselves, kill each other, while they go underground and then rein in a new paradigm shift, which is going to be a fusion of corporatism and communism, you know, under a one world authority. And then they're really going to clamp down on anybody even questioning the globe. Then it's the big sleep. Then it's the, like in the Matrix. Because the other thing too that's coming too is they got life extension technology that they want to tap into. They want to replace everybody with androids. Because everybody's redundant.
Yep.
Google bought up all the androids. But in order to turn on the artificial intelligence in these walking, moving artificial human beings, because NSA and Facebook has been, you'll enjoy this one as a software guy. What they've been doing is they've been like recording algorithms of human behavior vis-a-vis another human being. Like, I'm having an argument with my girlfriend on my phone over text messages because she doesn't want to talk to me. I'm having an argument with my boss because he doesn't want to talk to me. I'm negotiating a contract with somebody over Facebook or Gmail. They have the algorithms, the psychological algorithms of human interaction,
yeah,
all recorded. So, but to hand over the private communications of all these human beings around the planet to actually put these algorithms in the brains of artificial humans, they need to have a paradigm shift, and they need to get rid of the American Constitution and the to hand over the privacy laws and human rights and all that stuff. So they need to have Russian Chinese. They need to basically have the Russians and the Chinese and that model control the United States, and then go in there like the Allied forces went into the Nazi labs. Oh, look at all this information, all these experiments you've been doing. We'll take that. So then they go in the NSA, they go into Facebook, they take all the algorithms, they take go into Google, they go in and they take all the Androids because they it's an invasion. They've taken over. They've taken over Coca-Cola. They've taken over like whoever took over Volkswagen from Hitler. They take over all these companies, whatever they own, their assets, the NSA, and they go, you know what, why don't we just take all these algorithms now that we don't have the American Constitution protecting human rights and privacy, and that's your artificial intelligence. Man, you got a fucking computer, a brain, an artificial brain, that has all of the data of the World Wide Web in the brain of that android.
Formidable, to say the least.
So Elon Musk, who's the founder of Tesla and also the founder of SpaceX, he's done a ton of stuff with artificial intelligence and advanced computers and all that fancy stuff. He is warning us about, well, let's listen to him directly.
I think we should be very careful about artificial intelligence. If I were to guess at what our biggest existential threat is, it's probably that. So we need to be very careful with artificial intelligence. I'm increasingly inclined to think that there should be some regulatory oversight at the national and international level, just to make sure that we don't do something very foolish. With artificial intelligence, we are summoning the demon. We are summoning the demon. Stories where there's the guy with the pentagram and the holy water, and he's like, yeah, you sure you can control the demon? Didn't work out.
I take it there will be no Hell 9000 going up to Mars.
Hell 9000 would be easy. It's way more complex than, I mean, good.
It's best to prepare for to try to prevent a negative circumstance from occurring than to wait for it to occur and then be reactive. So, and this is a case where the potential, the range of negative outcomes, some of them are quite severe. So it's not clear whether we'd be able to recover from some of these negative outcomes. In fact, you can construct scenarios where recovery of human civilization does not occur.
That's amazing, but you did just invest in a company called Vicarious Artificial Intelligence. What is this company?
Right. I was also an investor in DeepMind before Google acquired it. I'd like to just keep an eye on what's going on with artificial intelligence. I think there's potentially a dangerous outcome there, and we need to...
Dangerous?
Potentially, yes.
So?
I mean, there's been movies about this, Terminator.
Yes, but movies are, even if that's the case, what do you do about it? I mean, what dangers do you see that you can actually do something about?
I don't know.
So you want to make sure that technology is used for good and not Terminator like evil?
Yeah. I mean, in the movie Terminator, they didn't create AI they didn't expect, some sort of Terminator-like outcome. It's sort of, like that Monty Python thing. Nobody expects the Spanish Inquisition. It's just like, but you got to be careful. So you want to make sure that...
I have two illustrious guests here with me. One is Philip Lowe, who's the inventor of the iBrain and founder and CEO of the company NeuroVigil. Our other guest is Elon Musk, who really needs no introduction, but he's also at the helm of the private space company, SpaceX. So thank you so much for joining me, guys.
Glad to be here.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
So, Philip, I want to know a little bit about this iBrain, and I understand that there's a new version.
Yeah. So, well, the iBrain is the world's first mobile brain monitor, in the sense, and that this is iBrain 3. The first one, though, did fit in Tic Tac boxes. So we've gone from, you know, from one level of dental hygiene to another. But this is. So, well, the thing is, I'm an accidental entrepreneur. And before that, I was an accidental neuroscientist. And before that, I was a mathematician. And then it wasn't until Stephen Hawking asked me to help him with his ALS that I became really involved in trying to access consciousness in humans. I think the previous work that I had done on consciousness in animals was more to sort of show some of the basic similarities in terms of the neurobiology. But, you know, it's very interesting how these things work. I think when you're passionate, you really don't know why you do things. Because if you did, you may actually have some sort of control over them.
Another bet that you made with yourself, I guess. I mean, a kind of crazy bet. You'd made some money from the sale of PayPal. You decided to build a space company. Why on earth would someone do that?
Got that question a lot. That's true. People would say, did you hear that? You're summoning the demon. You're summoning the demon.
Would humanity become a spacefaring civilization? So that was a dream of yours in a way from a young age, or like you dreamed of Mars and beyond?
I did build rockets when I was a kid, but I didn't think I'd be involved in this. It was really more from the standpoint of what are the things that need to happen in order for the future to be an exciting and inspiring one. And I really think there's a fundamental difference if you sort of look into the future between a humanity that is a space-faring civilization that's out there exploring the stars on multiple planets. And I think that's really exciting. And compared with one where we are forever confined to Earth until at some eventual extinction event. The future to be an exciting and inspiring one.
And you're summoning the demon.
On multiple planets. And I think that's really exciting. And compared with one where we are forever confined to Earth until at some eventual extinction event.
See?
Where we are forever confined to Earth.
Did he just do a fence with his hands?
We are forever confined.
One where we are forever confined to Earth until at some eventual extinction event.
See? He's such a little kid actor, it's not funny. Something's seriously wrong here. This guy's allowed to build missiles, shoot them up at the sky. Iran can't, North Korea can't, everybody can't, but this guy can. It's a missile. A rocket's a missile. And he's investing in what he says could be the downfall of mankind, humankind. Artificial intelligence. And he's investing in androids, artificial humans. So, there's a message being conveyed here. I'm building stuff to get people out to Mars. See, they're all going to go on these rockets thinking they're going to escape Mars. They're just going to go across the ice. They're going to leave while the robots seal you all in. Well, they bought time making you think it was a globe so you wouldn't go to the edge. See, in the 1500s, 1600s, you know, the powers all knew that, you know, a flat earth with a finite edge, a square, it's not going to hack it with the people when boat technology starts to advance. You know, Q, you say it's a square and it's just drops off. Well, I'm going to go check that out. I got this feeling that's bullshit. People would have gone to the edge, seen that it wasn't dropping into space. And it wasn't a square. It was ice. What, was a ball? No, they told you it was a ball because then it was fait accompli. You wouldn't go down to the South Pole and freeze your ass off. You know there's no land down there. It's just a little patch of ice. You think it's a ball spinning in space. You're not going to go check the edge of a flat earth that was a square. Do you understand? They threw it at you so that you wouldn't go check. That's the deception here. There's more land. That's what this is about. The square flat earth, people have been like, well, I'm gonna go and check that edge. I wanna see out in the space. Hey, we should do a tour. Maybe have a campsite right on the ice wall and then people could look down into space and see the stars. Oh my God, it'd be so trippy to see us rising in space on this thing. We don't know how it rises. I bet you people are going, fuck you, there's an edge. I bet you there's another area. You're just hiding land. I bet you back then they were saying that shit when it was flat. They knew the boats were going to get good. So they said, we got to come up with something when nobody's going to go check the ice wall. Tell them it's a ball. Does that work out, Copernicus? Yeah. Or they never went to the edge and they just wanted to sell the ball and they assumed it was a ball. And that's why they used that as an excuse not to go any further, because they were lazy and they didn't want to go in the ice, because they didn't have boats. They assumed it, and it wasn't. It was flat. Now they can't tell you. And there's land, and they're hiding it from you. That's the other scenario. They came to realize they were wrong. They're hiding it from you because it's benefits. This guy isn't going to Mars. That's a ruse, a camouflage for another operation. Now in this case we have a technology to go fly. He's going to make everybody think they're suiting up to go to Mars while the robots are sealing off the fence. And they're going to take a little trip across the ice. They're going to go, why aren't we going up? Well, we're going that way. We're never going, why, we haven't been going up. Shut up. Just let me fly the plane here. This is a plane? I thought this was a rocket. Just bear with me. Oh my God, look outside the window. What is this place? This is Narnia, baby. Welcome to Narnia. Or whatever it is. Atlantis. Atlantis is the other Earth. They call that section Atlantis. And in Atlantis, they have a myth, much like we have a myth of Atlantis on Earth. And the myth over in Atlantis is the myth of Earth. Across the ice. See, if it was a square, by now you would have had the boat. I'm fucking taking my motorboat. Fuck this ice wall shit. Drop it off into space. I'm going to check. Hey! You know, like, there's a Navy. You're not going to check the edge of the square. No, it'd be too much to handle. Too many people would be charging the square. Charging the edge of the square. Like, be just like, let's push, I want to see the edge. No, you throw a globe at them, you say it's just like solid ice, it freezes to death down there. Anyways, it's a globe, trust us. Here it is, perfect system. How does the day work? Oh, we spin around the sun. Oh yeah, that makes sense now. But how come, how come I can't feel the spin? That's like, that must be an enormous amount of speed and weight. How come I can't feel that shit? Magical force, suction. Big thing has suction. And in that bot time, while they held us, the rest of us back, and we finally woke up to, this is always a painting. The fuck is going on here? But then some people are back at this with an edge. Go further. They're hiding land. That's why they threw a globe at you. And they knew there was land. And after the American colony revolt, that's when they decided to, no more. These guys can't behave. Why don't we kidnap kids and we'll send in child settlers that are programmed? Who knows? But it ain't a ball. I'll tell you that right now. It ain't a ball. I'm sorry. Very dangerous, because these planes right now that are flying over the sky are drones.
Yeah.
They're fucking drones. Going across like lawnmowers.
That's like Prince William just pressing a button when he wakes up in the morning, for all I know, and just spraying the planet. It's at that point. It's at that fucking point. And everybody accommodates that traffic. Like, I've seen them when they're spraying, commercial air traffic goes lower. You know, so everything goes lower to accommodate the spraying. So I see World War III as the big distraction and also the paradigm shift to create the big sleep and to get rid of most of these human beings that are waking up, or most human beings, and then get back to slavery, which is the android. They like it when human labor doesn't cost anything. They like slaves. Obviously, they're spraying you. They've had slaves. Newton had slaves. Aristophanes had slaves and would drink their blood. Matter of fact, I think Plato's cave was actually a real-life MK-Ultra mind control experiment conducted in Greece.
Really?
I think Plato's cave is not an allegory. I think that was like one of the first mind control experiments. The data they would have gotten from that kind of experiment. And they kind of sell it in philosophy as an allegory. Well, that's a great cover-up. I mean, this is back in the day when you had slaves 3,000 years ago with Aristotle and Plato. So the slaves have kids. Hey, why don't we take the kids, because they're our property, put them in a cave, and make them think the shadows on the wall are reality. Let's see at what point we could shape a human brain. That's a lot of invaluable data. For the elite or the ruling elites to accumulate on the human mind, on how to program it. Here enters 2,000 years later globalism and how to basically. I'm telling you, this is, I could say I believe this, but it's like, hey, look, listen. If I could think it, you better hope there wasn't somebody with a budget. The idea that all the land was discovered. This is the motive for the deception. So let's look at all these flat earthers that suddenly showed up and their speculative models. Well, we have an enclosed system here from one gentleman. We have another enclosed system from another man. We have another enclosed finite system from another man. We have another enclosed finite system from another man. Of course, as you're listening to this, you're hearing a male's voice. However, being brought up with just a family of women, I have a greater understanding for pushing the limits of my imagination. And I'm very blessed to have been brought up with such imaginative, beautiful sisters. All three of them. And it was because of this warm, beautiful, uncompetitive upbringing, I'm able to actually push the boundaries and the tendencies of a male ego or male need to actually see an edge of property. The edge of property for a man defines the very success of that man. So when I see an edge with the flat earth model, I go, okay, here we go again. Some man trying to define himself through his property line. Let's look at the UN flag. Let's look at it very, very carefully. We have people go, well, there's the flat earth. But we're omitting two other details in the logo design, which is blatantly right in your face. We have some sort of concentric grid of white lines. Oh, it goes the white lines of the 33 sections of the, what 33 sections? Now, if the United Nations is basically going to be the vehicle, since the League of Nations, to bring about a one-world government. Now, that one-world government may only happen through the ashes of World War III, but as we look at this design, we see very clearly the Burini map. You see the Flat Earth map, except Antarctica is not in it. We do, however, see a bunch of white lines. Now, let's look at the last white rung on this map. Well, that would probably be, well, the perimeter of the flat earth section. Some say, well, that's where it ends and it drops off into space. Men, mostly. And unfortunately, that's a product of male indoctrination. And the edge of the property syndrome. The edge of the property syndrome.
that last white rum can be also, if you look at it from another angle, be your fence. And the fence is basically 47 nations and their navies coordinating together to keep people out of the South Pole. Unless, of course, they're sanctioned, they're coming in on one of the specified cruise ships to take pictures of the penguins, and they've been authorized by the Southern Antarctic Treaty Project. So when I see someone push an enclosed dome, you know what they're doing? Is they're infiltrating the Flat Earth Revolution to go and explore more land past the South Pole and infiltrating it with the exact New World Order they're building on this flag. And isn't it just like a man to define himself and his achievements through the edge of his property line? So I would be very leery of any Flat Earth model that enters this debate that shows you an edge. Because in the end, if you unquestioningly accept a Flat Earth that has an edge over a ball which has the same edge, you're still in the cage. You're still in the box. You're still in a bubble. And you don't get it. They're hiding land. That's why they did all the maps for you. So you don't think there's another big chunk. It's not that we live in an enclosed system. It's that they're building one. This is a cage that's going to be enforced by androids, and you'll never get out.
They don't care if the Flat Earth Revolution starts now, because it might be too late. From 1913 to 2015, not including a third world war, us finally waking up to the fact that there's only one image of the Earth from the Apollo 17 mission, and they play with the contrast to make you think there's thousands, but you only have one, and they use it in science books. It's 2015, and they don't even have any real-time camera footage of the Earth as a ball from space spinning in real-time video. And they make you think that the New World, or the New Worlds, are up there while they're doing something. They're distracting you. You ever think about it? I'm telling you, there's more land. There's extra territory. There's extra land. I'm being extraterrestrial. Get it?
So, that's all I have to say. Watch out for those disinformation agents, right? Disinformation is the process of deformation of the form, the real form that I tried to inform you. You have inform. What's information? Well, that's formation. From inside your mind, I inform you. I create a form inside you, the information process of giving you a form inside you, where the subject actually thinks that the form, the thought, is from themselves. That's information. All people want to understand form of something, form of a thought. Let's say a thought is a thought form. But how do you know when a form is a deformation of the actual form? The
process of making you think a deformation is information is disinformation. Then you become misinformed. Misinformation. A lot of people don't know that, but they're misinformed because there's disinformation going on against the real form. It's been going on for a long time. Now, when a movement begins the reformation process of the actual form and transmit the new form through the information process or the reinformation or the inri formation process or the reformation process of the actual form, once again, you'll have agents deforming it through the disinformation process. So you are misinformed. Once you've been disinformed and you think you're armed with information and you go out speaking, you'll come up against the other argument, the argument of control. Let's say globalism and flat earth as an example. Because through this entire campaign, I have now proven my thesis on disinformation agents, the disinformation mechanics, and the process. This is how disinformation works. You're turned on by the idea, hey, wait a minute. People think the earth is a ball because they got pictures that glue together an equation from priests that work at the Vatican. And they're blown away. And then they go back to their senses. Yeah, I look at the horizon. Shit, that boat's disappearing. It must be a curve. Wait a minute, telescope. It's still fucking there. How's it still there if it's a fucking ball dropping 8 inches every square mile? Because it's supposed to be curving. But I still see it for like, you know, 1,000 fucking kilometers. It's flat. So they're blown away. They look at the UN flag. That's a flat earth map. That's taken from the actual original flat earth society. Blown away. But they've bullied everybody intellectually. Oh, that's back when people were stupid and they thought the earth was flat. So you don't go there. Since you were born, you've been brainwashed. Anything but a ball is stupidity. But you've never seen the ball. So you're blown away by what I'm telling you. Now, it starts to take hold like a virus, like a mind virus. It starts like creating a revolution. And I'm a revolutionary. What happens now is they activate the disinformation campaign. This is how it works. What they'll do is they'll set up other flat earth theorists or pseudo-revolutionaries. Now, these are conscious or unconscious. They could be programmed through Robert Sweet's patent, where they triangulate subliminal, superliminal messages into the subject's mind, the target individual's mind, who might be a little religious, might be a zealot, upset with society, doesn't like globalism, and then they adhere to this theorem. Then there's the conscious ones that are paid through the CIA and other counterintelligence agencies. And their job is to set up a channel, set up a platform, create a group, a blog, whatever, and then attract. They'll take half of what you say, which is palpable, half of it, point at the exact same flaws that we see in globalism and NASA and the lunar landing, all that. Then they'll adhere or twist or invert one thing so your whole theory looks ridiculous. Then what happens is then a support team of other disinformation agents, conscious or unconscious, paid or unpaid, gravitate towards the site. Some of them, that's their salary, to go and support this agent in his campaign to begin the discrediting of the science, the logic, the argument, the proofs. If it's not a ball, how is it that I can go from Los Angeles to Paris? Okay, so let's do that. Los Angeles, Paris. Well, wait a minute. How can I go from Paris to Siberia? Well, just keep going. Going, you almost made a full circle. Going around in circles on a flat plane doesn't mean it's a
ball going around circles on a floor doesn't make the house a ball. You know? Just because you went around in a big circle doesn't mean it's a ball. Ha ha, it's a sphere. I flew around the world. No, you flew around in a big circle. Following GPS. Because you only have a certain amount of gas to get around the world. Some guys go up and they just go around and around a couple times. Why don't you go under the South Pole completely? You know? And not one of these staged excursions that just stay on the coast but make you think you're going deep in, or you're going right to the point and then back out the way you came but not continuing straight across. And not these double traverses where there's no witnesses, or it's like an ex-military scientist or a UN shill. I mean, that's a big, huge security for the sake of science. That's what the Southern Antarctic Treaty Project is. No activity beyond that point entering into the South Pole unless for scientific reasons. Yeah. To secure science. All of it. Jarl Landahoy, though, got picked up within just a couple hours. How'd they know he was there? He went in unannounced. He went in unannounced twice. Read up on him. Jarl Landahoy. He left from New Zealand the second time, and there were cops running down the stairs on the dock as his little sailboat took off with the repairman who was working on it still in the hull to go see what happened to his friends that were probably murdered. Within a week of Jarl Landahoy leaving New Zealand, Williams do a search and rescue around the Falkland Islands. Interesting. Just impromptu. This is real, real like archaic. You know, people with scepters and crowns trying to control all the cattle in the fence.
Weak man and the bully. Weak man and the bully.
I gotta live. So, saying the earth is flat, not having Wi-Fi, and then having to respond to people, and having to drive 20 miles just to go and respond to somebody who's starting to think the sky is some sort of glass dome. There's a force of energy at the top, which Tesla tapped into with his experiments, which HARP taps into in Alaska. And what it is basically you have air, or what we call ether, the medium between things, form. Get right back down to Aristotle here, because if it isn't a globe, and heliocentrism is a weird solar worship hoax cult where people got sacrificed under obelisks by the same people who said it was a ball and drank their blood. This happened like 2,000 years ago. People had slaves, you know? Sir Isaac Newton was a slave owner. He had slaves. You know, Benjamin Franklin, these people had slaves, okay? The principles of their world, or what they think the world should be, are the principles we have today. And these people had slaves. The people who are the scholars, the giants of physics, had slaves, right? I'm no fucking slave. And if you're a black man thinking this is a color issue with World War III or like the U.S., you're just playing into the whole divide and conquer, the old Jesuit tactique, which they're doing with the Jews and the Muslims. Best part of it. Atheist, physicist, who believes in science. This is from a Catholic priest. Do you know his name? Who said the earth was a ball? That's right. Nicholas Copernicus. Nicholas Copernicus was a Jesuit priest. And then you go, well, Big Bang Theory, and the universe started with a Big Bang. That's science. You know, so it wasn't created by somebody with a concept of like organizing information, every anatomical piece of matter that is interdependent and works so beautifully together, like a tree, like my hand with five fingers, not six, just perfect amount of everything, just enough, not two thumbs, one thumb, everything, my senses, all this information came out of a Big Bang. Everything came out of nothing. But guess what? The Big Bang Theory? It's another Jesuit priest. That's right. You don't even know who came up with the theory. You think it's Einstein. No. It's Georges Lemaître, the master in French. George the Master. And he's a Jesuit priest. You know, there's a reason why the Jesuits have the most powerful telescopes to look into space. There's a reason. because all of science, apparently, flows from Jesuit priests. They're all part of the theater of war. They're setting the stage for war. And I know, and it seems to me like when it started really, like I called it in 2011, 12, and I called it like way even before that, but I couldn't upload. Watch, they're gonna like try to have a war with Russia to distract everybody as people start waking up to deception after deception until they get to the final big one. And just before they could wake up to that one, too late, World War III. So this is the situation. So the second viral video, the second type of viral over YouTube is the splinter cell concept, where the video is now, it's not one video at 20 million in 48 hours, it's like hundreds of videos of the same topic through hundreds of channels, but 5,000 here, 100,000 there, 20,000 here, 30,000 there. So I believe we're now at that level, which, you know, you can control a lot of traffic, like mind traffic with the internet, and you can kind of ideologically sort of engineer what people are going to be distracted or attracted to. But at a certain point, the machine itself is its own monster to the person who created it. And in this sense, it's our monster. But we're in that time frame right now with Netanyahu wanting to fucking bomb Iran. And you got President Obama almost looking like the last 2 years, I'm like, all right, now I'm going to be black. You know what I mean? Like, I think there's a possibility. I think he does know. Because when he kind of like made that little punchline, I was like, you know, about the flat earth when he was doing his speech.
Oh, yeah, we don't have time to talk to the flat earth.
But right? He stuttered.
They must have been founding members of the Flat Earth Society. They would not have believed that the world was round.
Yeah. I was just blown away when I saw that.
He stuttered, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, no.
In some sort of conversation at the upper level.
Oh, yeah. And then you saw, I think it was somebody else, some other senator or somebody else, he stuttered too. And it's like, either you really think it's idiotic and you have no problem with the comedic timing on that punchline, or you know something about what the heck is going on. And for me, the body language and the stuttering... Oh yeah, he said flat earth. Okay, programming. Oh yeah, we must laugh at that because that's stupid. And then they laughed. There was a pause because he fucked up his timing. But people are so brainwashed with anything that's flat earth is obviously you're stupid. Then they caught it because of their conditioning, not because of his delivery. Because he fucked up his delivery. And he fucked up his delivery because there was a lot of pressure on delivering that line.
Yeah.
Because there's
and,
been...
And since that line, because... You know, that script was made way in advance.
It's
like, okay, who in what rooms are talking about this, and why bring, you know, it's like they're being proactive in advance. It's like, let's remind people, for no apparent reason,
like
that
bullying.
Answers are crazy.
Yeah. And I don't think Francois Hollande knows. In France. I think Sarkozy knows. I don't think Merkel knows in Germany. Like, they have certain people so that the theater looks real, are like working in good intentions. So then here enters Merkel and Hollande going to Russia to broker a peace deal, which bought some time. Because nobody really wants to go to war. But Putin knows and Barack Obama knows. But they're playing their role in this whole thing. I don't think William and I don't think Harry knows, but I know Charles and Philip know, and I know the Queen of England knows.
Well, of course.
I know Tony Blair knows. I don't know if Cameron knows. It's fucked up what I'm saying right now, but it's like I'm going on intuition, like from body language, from the way they are, and what we need on the geopolitical stage to make the... You need a few that are out in the dark to make the liars who could be caught lying look real. You know what I mean?
I know exactly what you're saying. Because,
theater.
If you let enough people, you know, at the higher levels know, you eliminate them from the equation of accidentally stepping into something they shouldn't be.
Exactly.
You know, like any politician. You know, every once in a while you get those politicians like, I think we should look into JFK, you know, and then it's like, all of a sudden it's like, no, dude, you're not talking about JFK.
want me to knock you in the head?
Well, I want you to swear to God on the Bible that you walked on the moon.
Okay.
If you walked on the moon, we're given the opportunity to swear to God that you walked on the moon.
I'm going to give you the opportunity to get the hell knocked out of you if you don't leave me alone.
So why don't you just put the into the record in the argument and put your hand on the Bible, swear to God you walked on the moon.
Mr. Cyril, knowing you, that's probably a fake Bible.
Well, you're talking to the wrong guy. Why don't you talk to the administrator in NASA? We're passengers. We're guys going on a flight.
I don't hit people, but you're going to be on the deck unless you get
I'm heading out. I appreciate it.
And get the hell out of my house.
It's okay. Well, I take your stuff and get the fuck out.
Why don't you quote me and say it's bullshit?
I'm in the shadows in the wrong place. I don't give a damn about all that shit.
Shit of lunar orbit being falsified.
Being falsified?
Correct. We've got an unedited tape from a source at the Johnson Space Center.
Yes. Totally nonsense.
Mr. Cybrill, you do not deserve answers.
If you show this publicly, you're open for a lawsuit. Okay?
Support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
And
I, William Jefferson Clinton, do solemnly swear.
I, William Jefferson Clinton, do solemnly swear.
That I will faithfully execute the office of President.
So that, you know, like, I think it's an audit on images and what's real that was bound to happen. That's the alien invasion. They might fake one in the sky. They might have whatever. Something might show up, but it's fake. Because if that's fake, that's fake. And if the sky and the clouds are fake, that's fake. And that's fake. This is the alien invasion. This is the invasion. It's from within the mind. Your judgment day. You gotta choose. Whether it's a ball or it's flat. That's it. If you wanna like choose it's a ball quietly knowing it's flat because you're scared, that's your deal. You wanna choose it's flat and then you're gonna lose it and then go into a war, I don't advocate that. I'm a gentleman, I pay. I'm not into any kind of like freak out. This whole point. This is like a soft core mass humiliation project of the world's ruling elite. Just all of us stepping back and going, it's, you know what, it's not a ball anymore. No, we're not buying it. That's all this is. I mean, do you really think that you got supervision? Like, if it's flat, I will see it forever. Now, because things get small. From the distance, they get smaller. You know, you don't have like the supervision. You know, just because it's flat doesn't mean you could see forever. Okay, I'm gonna show you an example. And you might think this is stupid, but you know what? Let's take all your senses. Let's take hearing, okay? So, I'm gonna talk. I'm gonna turn this around, okay? I'm gonna walk away from you, okay? I'm gonna walk away from you. Okay, can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Hey, I'm talking to you. He goes over here. Look, way over here. Look. Still hear me? Still hear me? How loud is it now? Hey, you know what? I'm still talking at the same level. Still, like, I'm not talking any louder. I'm talking at the same level. You know? Still talking. Still going. Still talking. You know? Coming back. I'm coming back now. Here I am. Did you stop hearing me? Because the sound disappeared beyond the Earth's curve? You mean I'm wrong? You mean my senses have fooled me? Do you really think God would give you all these senses, or the architect, or the force, if you don't like the word God, the thing that created the orchid and the bees, harmonic, interdependent evolution, which is beyond what Darwin can explain from monkeys to humans. Do you really think that force would have fooled you by giving you senses to think that it's flat and infinite and make it grounded? And you don't feel a spin, but it's spinning and going up and down 1,000 miles an hour, 65,000 miles an hour, like this, but you don't feel that because of a magical force that only starts its argument by saying, if the Earth is a ball, then objects are at rest because. That's not an argument to prove it's a ball. That's an argument to prove it's a ball by saying, if it's a ball. And then you want to tell me clouds don't change, baby boomer. Or, it's not about baby boomer. Because it's also dumb little parrots who are possessed. Now, I want to talk about the schism when you're faced with all this. You either turn from the light, because we're talking about the light here, and you go back to the image of the beast from the military, which is an invisible religion, by the way. You worship it. If you believe that's the earth, because you don't know it, you believe. It's a belief. Therefore, a religion. A cult. You've never seen that point of view. You believe the earth is a ball. You believe they went to the moon. Therefore, you believe in... That's a religion. I have intuition. I see fraud when I see it. And I have a hyper-realist, tangible scrutiny of what's presented as evidence of the surface I stand upon and how energy works. And what you told me about the monkey and the man, the leaf and the tree and the rock I stand upon. And when and where and how. Jesuits, armed science. Once again, you atheists that believe in just science and not religion, you are believing in Jesuit priests. So what are you gonna do with that? Hate me some more. Hate. I fucking love being hated by those who are possessed. Oh, and you think this is scary? Wait till the boots are on the ground. And I don't know what's worse, the globalists in the West or the globalists in China and Russia who've been fed this false sense of pride by the fact they give a lift to the Americans to the space station. Somebody's got to get to the Russians, too, about all this. See, things break. Things break. You thought this was just a regular brush, and I was just sort of playing around with it, and oops, it broke. And it's just that easy. Things just break. Time-lapse footage of the Earth from space, video footage sped up, but the clouds don't mutate. If it's a ball, why are you faking all the footage? Huh? Why are you faking the size of continents relative to real driving distance from one coast of Canada to the other and Russia on a toy globe? If it's a ball, it's a ball. Put everything to scale. You tell me you could fit Canada twice into the length of Russia? If it's a ball, why are you faking everything? If it's a ball, why does it look like a cartoon? If it's a ball, why do people say, I believe it's a ball? If it's a ball. But why is it still the theory of gravity? You didn't prove it. You only need the theory of gravity if it's a ball. That's how the whole equation starts. So, it's not a ball. We don't need gravity. Gravity's just there to explain why the fucking shit's not flying off if we're spinning 1,000 miles an hour. It's temperature. This is ether. This is air, gas, whatever you want to call it, ether. The original word was ether. You know, the spaces between things. And it's got a temperature. If it gets too cold, I get affected. If it gets too hot, my skin will melt off. Underneath me is stuff that'll melt my skin. We see it shoot out of volcanoes. I got dirt, rock, minerals, maybe oil, deposits. Then I got lava. Don't talk to me about the candy center, the gobstopper earth where there's layers of candy bar with like a chewy chocolatey center that's nickel or iron. Or I used to ask in geography. And then underneath the lava is iron. And I'm like, how'd you get through the lava to know there's iron? Matt, get out of class. Call me disruptive. They call me disruptive in geography. The class would laugh, but I would be kicked out because I was making jokes. No, I was a sincere question. How do you know the center of the earth is nickel if you got to go through, you know, this many hundreds of miles of molten magmic lava? It's funny, eh? The center of your earth is cartoons. Your maps are cartoons. Those aren't the real sizes of the countries. The toy globe is inaccurate. It's a toy. That's how inaccurate it is. It's a toy globe. But apparently, you can't make everything to scale if it's a globe. As long as it's three parts water. Here's the North Pole. Going around in circles on a floor doesn't mean you're on a sphere. Looking up at circular lights or a moon, celestial body that's circular, doesn't mean you're on a circle. You're on a sphere. Just because you got a lack of choice up there to reference doesn't mean the one object up there must mean that's what you're on. Well, I don't have a chair floating. It's not a cow. The only thing I see up there is a round thing. Well, then I must be on that. That's a little primitive. Think about it. And somebody can control that. Maybe you're just within bigger spaces between celestial phenomenon than you think. And it's not even Star Trek here. It's not space with planets and stuff like that. You never see those pictures of like Jupiter when you look at a through a mechanical telescope. You need to like hub into a digital